Transparency disclaimer. Always provide a code, and this game breakdown is brought to you by Evolve Terminal. Hello everyone and welcome to Game Breakdown, I'm Nordegraf, and today we're going to be talking about a game called Sphinx and the Cursed Mummy. If you've heard of this game, that's because this game originally came out in 2003 on the PlayStation 2, GameCube, and Xbox. Since then, it's been released on a couple of different platforms, including, well, PC, and today we're going to be talking about the Steam release of this game. The port started out a little bit rough, to be entirely honest. It was quite buggy back when I started, but the devs have been like working overtime to make sure that the game is running well, and since its release, it's been working perfectly for me. It used to have some frame drop issues, especially with the particle effects, that I had to turn down a bunch of graphics, but it's working great now, and I had quite a bit of fun with it. The game, you're basically this Sphinx guy that has to collect these jars to save the cursed mummy, which is a prince, and you have to collect these jars so you can restore the prince's soul and save the world from the sad guy. In this game you can actually control two characters. You can control Sphinx, which has the ability to combat, use a variety of gadgets, and you can also control the cursed prince, whose gameplay is more focused on stealth than anything else, and solving puzzles like using certain elements like lightning and fire to activate certain switches and so on and so forth. There's a bunch of collectibles. For example, you gotta collect animals, you gotta capture these creatures for the museum, you gotta get golden unks to increase your life, and it's actually quite fun. The game progresses quite well, there's quite some cool puzzles in it. It was never too hard for me. There's this one boss specifically that I remember being very obtuse, and a couple of puzzles that I found to be kind of hard to figure out, but some of it, most of it, were due to my own stupidity. But the game itself was very fun. The only issue I encountered with the game was the ziplines. The ziplines are very finicky and unforgiving at times, where you have to be at the very start for the zipline to attach and you'll be able to use it, but that's a very minor gripe with the game. It's not something you have to do often, and it's not something that took away from my enjoyment of the game. The only thing I would really complain about this game is that the end feels very rushed. Once you get about halfway through the game, it feels like the game just rushes through to the end, and the game just ends. 10 to 15 hours should be your time of the game if you're just rushing through it, trying to 100% complete it. If you're just trying to beat it, I would say probably about 6 to 8 hours, give or take, if you're just trying to get to the end of the game as fast as you can. I would say for $15, the game is quite a good deal. It's a very fun game. I had fun with it, and I enjoy myself very much. It's a game that I missed playing at the time, but that I'm very glad that it got released on PC so I could experience it myself. I hope you experience it as well. The game is currently around $10 on Steam due to Steam sales, so it's definitely a game I recommend you at least have a look at to see if you enjoy it or not. The game has graphics very reminiscent of Jak and Daxter for me, and also puzzle mechanics kind of like Zelda. Each dungeon feels very Zelda-ish, so it's definitely a game, if you like those games, it's definitely a game I recommend you pick up.
Although I would warn you, if you're thinking of getting the game, to not rely on autosaves. This is very much an older game where you had to save all the time. You have save points, so use them.
This has been Game Breakdown. I'm Nordegraf, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Catch you on the flip side. Bye-bye.